Yes, I'm Amanda Ellis. I'm the Vice President of Search at Special Counsel, a national legal search firm. And I'm going to share 7 tools for recruiting and job searching. So whether you're looking to hire or looking for a job, there's something here for you. For those of you who are looking to hire, one of your challenges with job boards might be the volume of resumes you receive. You may not have time to review all of them, or the ones you do review aren't a match for the jobs you're looking to fill. So there's a new site available called workable.com. This site actually screens resumes for you based on certain requirements that you set. So let's take a closer look at how it works. First, you're able to set requirements, must-have requirements for your job. And so let's say you're looking to hire a paralegal and you want the paralegal to have a bachelor's degree. You would set here that you want your candidates to have a bachelor's degree. Workable will screen the resumes and will only send you the resumes of candidates who have that degree. Second, you can set questions that you want candidates to respond to when they send in their resumes. So let's say you're hiring a patent agent or a patent prosecution attorney. You may pose the question, how many patent applications have you drafted? Then Workable shares your job post on different websites, such as Indeed and Simply Hired. It will also share your job post on social media sites, thereby increasing the visibility of your job. When people apply to the job, not only do you get the resume, but you get the LinkedIn profile of the person, as you see on the left, and then you get the answers to the questions that you pose to them. So you get a complete picture. A second site that's helpful for people looking to hire is a site called recruitin.net. Instead of trying to find people who are looking for jobs, this allows you to find those passive job seekers who aren't looking at job boards. So you fill in what you're looking for, paralegals in Dallas, and this site uses X-ray search techniques and tells Google to search LinkedIn's public profiles. So you're getting a broader mix of people than you would get if you just searched LinkedIn. A similar site is called followerwant.com. This site also searches for passive candidates who aren't looking at job boards, but it's finding those candidates on Twitter instead of on LinkedIn. It does so by searching Twitter bios. If you look in the upper left corner, there's a link that says search Twitter bios. You click on that and you get these search parameters. I like to enter the title of the position in the keyword field and then the location in the designated location field. Then your search results look something like this. You get the person's name, their Twitter name, where they're located, their bio, and then you can immediately follow them and connect with them from this screen. So it makes it easier. Another site, this one's available for job seekers, is called jackalopejobs.com. This site acts as a job aggregator, like Indeed. In the upper left-hand corner, you start your search. You're looking for jobs for lawyers in Dallas. Then when you get your search results, the site is pulling job postings from a variety of websites, job boards, and other websites. But notice the highlighted part. This is the key. It's finding who in your network works at these companies. It looks at your LinkedIn network and your Facebook network. So for this particular position, I can see that my Facebook friend, Wendy Johnson, works at CenturyLink, which has a job opening for a lawyer. So if I'm interested, I could contact Wendy. Similarly, a site called Who Works At, as you're reading websites where you might want to work, like Gardier, you click on the icon in the upper right, and it shows you your LinkedIn connections who work at this firm or this company. A 6th tool for job seekers is a site called SimpleWash, previously known as FaceWash. This site scans your Facebook profile for any unwanted content. That includes content that you've posted, such as pictures and posts, and comments that people have made on pictures you've posted, like you see here. It also includes content that you've been tagged in. So you have the opportunity to remove that content or to remove that tag. Finally, we have a site called 500plus.com, which allows you to set up a reminder to keep in touch with your LinkedIn connections. You drag your LinkedIn contact to the time frame you want, weekly, monthly, annually, quarterly, how often you want to get in touch with them. And then you get an email reminder saying it's time to reach out to that contact. Thank you.